My name is Murray Robertson and I'm 19 years old and I'm a full-time centre attendant here at the Galway Leisure Centre. Basically my job role as a centre attendant here is being a lifeguard 90% of the day, watching the pool, making sure the pool is safe to use and nobody drowns. And the other 10% of the time is taken up by doing off-pool duties such as cleaning the changing rooms in the other parts of the building, going through to do the system checks of the pool such as the chlorine, doing a pool test, making sure the chlorine levels are at safe levels, turning on and off the slide for any customers that bring kids in to use the facilities, and as well doing all the first aid checks. It all started off with me being a modern apprentice for Active Schools and East Ayrshire Council, working on different schools, and through that time I was able to obtain a lifeguard qualification, as two of the schools I worked in had swimming pools, and Gary thought it would be handy for me to have it in case any time where I needed to assist the school with their lessons during the day for the pupils, and it would be another handy member of staff on the pool side in the schools. And through that as well, I was very fortunate to be Skills Development Scotland's Modern Apprentice of the Year Level 2. And as I won that award and it came to the end of my apprenticeship, Gary advised me that there was a full-time job coming up here and recommended it for me, as it wouldn't just be beneficial for me being able to be a lifeguard here, but through my time here as well, I'm also a in-water swimming instructor, assistant. And my coaching that skills that I achieved with Gary would be very helpful to the Galway here as an in-water instructor. So I thought, with the end of my apprenticeship coming, I said, right, I'll take a little plunge at it. And I was successful in getting at it. And I've made probably one of the best decisions to come here. And it's been a fantastic time since I've started.
You can see he's an enthusiastic guy, always happy to go lucky. But at the same time, he's hard working. Already he's helping us with our swimming lessons as well as the centre attendant duties. He's done extra hours for us as well. So as a manager, that's excellent. It's something we can rely on. He's always at work on time and he's always enthusiastic and ready to do his work. So excellent team member for us.
The benefit from working with the older Murray, because the character he is, he's a very easy guy to get on with. The fact that he's got additional support means is something that we need to disclose to any of our members of staff. If he thinks he needs any additional support, then we'll give that. But essentially, we benefited from a young guy who's got the qualifications and everything, all the qualities we are looking for the members of staff at Galway. To reassure other businesses that it's something, there's no need to be worrying about it. Simply, we've recruited somebody who has brought a lot to the team. Would be very beneficial to the team as well. So I don't see, if there was anything else, extra training or anything like that, we'd provide that and we'd give them support through that. Murray would have had to do that a couple of times maybe to go over again. But I would certainly advise other companies or teams to just go for it. There's nothing to worry about, like you say.
Yes, I do think employers can be wary of recruiting somebody with additional support needs, because when I went for the interview I had to declare that I did have additional support needs, and when I went for my interview he did ask me what my additional support need was, and I basically said that there's certain jobs and certain things that I'll find harder to pick up on and it'll take time for me just to gradually get it into my head and get it and keep a rhythm going. And he had the perfect right to ask me, because some folk think this is just an easy job, standing in poolside, watching folks, swinging a whistle about the place, where in truth it's not, because out of the blue, you could be on poolside one day, somebody walks into the centre, drowns before you even think about it and loses their life. So it is a pretty serious job, and that's why I do think employers do need to be a wee bit wary of additional support needs. My advice to these employers out there across the authority and the nation would be that recruiting somebody with additional support needs isn't the worst idea in the world, because somebody with additional support needs can have the same quality of skills as you and I have, and myself included in here in this centre. From our monthly staff training, one of the examples, in our monthly staff training, we've got to be able to practice our rescue techniques, practice our timed swims so that we're physically fit and physically skilled to carry out a rescue in one flight in case of an emergency. And from what the staff training records show, I am the fastest member of staff in the centre that can swim the 20 metre rescue time. And for one of the rescue procedures, I'm not one of the slowest, but just under that borderline. But even though I'm bad at one thing, I'm the best at one thing, and that's what I think employers need to know, that even though some people with additional supports can be good at one thing and bad at another thing, they can still just do as good a job as any other person.